Hello, once again. I'm here still. West Virginia tomorrow. So, likely we'll be doing the watch-along stream in case anything pops up, but I'm still planning to go with it. Noon Eastern, FS1. Like, subscribe, comment, all those good things. Hit the notification bell when you want to know when my stream goes live. I'll put it out on Twitter, if Twitter still exists. Boy, Twitter might be going down the drain fairly quickly, the way it's being run by Elon. Good Lord, what a disaster that's turning into. But we're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about college football. And I know there's not a lot of positivity around this program right now, or a lot of negativity, and you know, we're just kind of waiting to see, hear some good news. I've been partially following recruiting myself, and there's some pending good news out there, but it's pending, meaning it's like not imminent. It's just, we're kind of waiting around to see what happens. You know, early signing period is about a month and a half away, about a month and 10 days, so like 40 days out, give or take. But so that's kind of where we're at right now for really, really good news. Winning tomorrow would help, and I think OU will win tomorrow. This, if you think we've had a bad season in the Big 12, West Virginia, so yeah, they're last place in the Big 12. I mean, I'm glad it's a noon kick. You know, get it out of the way. Let's watch it. Have a good time. I think OU will, if they can run the ball and cut down on the mistakes. So many mistakes last week. But I feel like a broken record in that department as well. But if you can run the football effectively, I think Dillon will be able to take advantage of their secondary. And now on the other side of the football, defensively, I think OU's going to be given fits because the defense is just, it is what it is right now. You just don't know what you're going to get. So at its worst, knock on wood saying worst, but at its worst, you'll give up 28, 31 points maybe. I think OU can score 40 plus if they do what they can do, if they can take advantage of certain one-on-one matchups and just run the ball with Eric Gray. I know some guys are a little dinged up from last week. I haven't had time to figure out anything with who's available or whatnot because I dealt with another hurricane. It was technically a hurricane, kind of was a tropical storm. Thankfully for me, this go-around, I did not lose power. I have internet, all is well. I got to avoid that fun little extended weekend of like going about 36 hours without power and then almost had to wait till Sunday early afternoon last time for internet to come back. But not this time. I had a few brownouts here and there where the power went off and came back on real quick. But happened about 5 or 6 times over the course of the storm. But you know what? I'd rather deal with that than what I went through last time. And I'm sure a lot of other people in Florida are dealing with way bigger issues than me right now when it comes to that. So hope everyone gets their power back soon for those in Florida. But other than that, just feeling pretty good today. Hurricane was a little rough day for me physically, but you know, just trying to get through the days as best as you can right now. And I'm feeling pretty good at the moment. So kind of like how I was feeling pretty good on Sunday. So I have my good days and I have my bad. So I'm just rolling through little bit by little bit and going to be here till the very end of the season and on to the next season because that's my plan and I'm sticking to it. But as of right now, not much to say. Just keep an eye on the rest of college football. I'm rooting for TCU to beat Texas because I just don't want Texas to be happy tomorrow. It's like, I'm not happy right now, therefore I don't want you guys to be happy. So anyway, that's really all I got for this preview. Pretty plain and simple. But yeah, I'll be here tomorrow, chilling. It's gonna be one of those games. Just sit back, relax, and hopefully we enjoy a win. Because next week's gonna be fun regardless. I don't care what records are. Throw the record books out. We're gonna have Bedlam next week. I think that's gonna go our way. Hopefully. I think that'll go our way. But boy, it's gonna be interesting nonetheless. I think we need a feel-good game, and whether we get it tomorrow or I think next week can be that feel-good game. We need that feel-good game. So, with that being said, Boomer Sooner, I will catch you all later tomorrow. And, yeah, just have a great weekend, everyone. Stay safe.